For the first time, Professor Naidu taught them how to cook the rice and how to eat the rice and prepare a curry also. So this is one of the important expeditions of Professor Naidu in his career, and he has got the Commendation Award for the Republic Day in the year 1998. Towards south, we have the Biosphere Reserve of Great Nicobar Island. It is an important island where the Chopin population are inhabiting, and the Chopins are distributed the Great Nicobar Island in different parts, which you can able to observe here. And this is the Campbell Bay, the headquarters of the Chopin population. Chopins are living in the areas of Galatia, Alexandria, Dagmar and Jubilee River basins and the sea coast. On the base of their concentration and their bands, Professor Naidu has divided into seven groups, such as: 1. The 35 kilometers group around the Chopin Hut complex. 2. Kotangari camp, those who are dwelling just above the east-west road. 3. Alexandria camp around the river Alexandria. 4. Dagmar camp, areas of Pillakunji and Dagmar river basins. 5. Area of Pokain, Piloba and Singambasti. 6. Lawful camp, including the areas of Lawful and Trinket. And finally, 27 kilometers camp, including the areas of settlements near the river Galatia. The Chopin who are living in Great Nicobar Island Biosphere Reserve are facing a threat of extinction. Once they are living happily in the island, now they are facing the problems of survival. Till 1960, most of the Chopins used to inhabit in the east coast of the Great Nicobar Island, where they used to get abundant pandanus fruits, pandanus, bamboo rice and wildlife. The rehabilitation of ex-military people in the east coast region became a threat for the survival of the Chopin, who have been pushed towards the interior forest. The construction of East Coast Road from Campbell Bay to Indira Gandhi Point is the important destruction which has been affected the biosphere directly. And the construction of the jetties in Campbell Bay, you can see here how they have been developing at a faster rate, which has been directly affected the Chopin population and the biosphere where they are living. Their flora, fauna was totally destroyed, and they have been pushed towards the west coast from the east coast. The fast growth of the tourism in Great Nicobar Island and also Andaman Islands are also affecting the very survival of the primitive tribes. Immigration is another important factor which affects the Great Nicobar Island and also the Andaman and Nicobar Island. It is observed that the Andaman and Nicobar Islands lost its carrying capacity because of migration of lot of people from the mainland to the island. The Chopin are facing lot of health problems. The most important one is the teeth problem, which you can observe here. They continuously chew the betel nut. That is why the teeth became colorish and also the teeth is decaying. Another important problem which they are facing is the scabies infection. Most of the Chopins are suffering with the scabies, which you can observe here. In the beginning, before my research started in 1993, most of them are thought they are suffering leprosy disease. The infection is more among the Chopins who are inhabiting in Dagmar and Jubilee river regions. Now you can see the fingers. It is almost looks like a leprosy, but it is not leprosy. It is mainly because of serious affection of scabies infection. During my research stay in Great Nicobar Island, we have given treatment with the help of the medical staff of Andaman Adimajati Vikas Samiti. Most of them are recovered in a 3 years period of our research. Another important health problem is most of them are suffering with gastrointestinal infection and also vitamin deficiency. Since 1990, that is after Jarva issue came into the limelight, the Andaman administration and the scholars has forgotten the protection, conservation and development of other tribes such as Shompen, Ongi, Great Andamanese and Sentinel. The worst affected are the Shompen tribe. No doubt the Andaman and Nicobar administration is supporting the Shompen, but it is limited to their survival. There is no deep involvement of the administration to save the Shompen population. It is mainly because of the lack of expertise, field staff and the development of the basic infrastructure in the Great Nicobar Island for the conservation of the Shompen population. After tsunami, no serious action was taken to rehabilitate the Shompen. There is no systematic data on the habitation, distribution and the present way of life the Shompen is leading. No doubt that the Shompen policy has been developed by the administration, but it is not implemented fully. We have very few research studies on Shompen available. After 1995, there is no research work has been taken up by any scholar seriously. Even today, most of them are referring the data published by the Bodanclaus, Mann, Chengappa, Agarwal and Professor T.S. Naidu. There is an urgent need to prepare a detailed ethnography, data, demography and population structure, physical anthropology, health and nutrition, and finally an action plan should be developed for the conservation of these Shompen population. The need of the hour is to formulate a policy, not by a non-anthropologist. An anthropologist should be given a free hand, whereas Jawaharlal Nehru has given a free hand to Premier Elvin to bring into the policies. That is why he prepared Panchashri, which is Jawaharlal Nehru has accepted and implemented. Here in India, there is no vision for the policy makers to take decisions by the concerned authorities or concerned academicians and research scholars. That is why I request the Prime Minister of India and the President of India and the policy makers at different levels and the administrators and bureaucrats, we have to take the concern and opinion of the anthropologist how to conserve the aborigines in India. That is very, very important. Otherwise, all these Bintu tribes may extinct from the planet, if not today or in the times to come. We cannot see any of the aborigines, not only in Andaman Islands, but also in mainland. That is why I have taken up the work Man in Search of Man series to document the ethnographic document and also to suggest to the policy makers through visual effects how to conserve this population. The Shompen are a distinct population living on the earth who remained virtually isolated, untouched by modern civilization. The Shompen inhabiting zones in Great Nicobar Island should be conserved and protected from the intrusion of the people from both India and foreign. The Shompen are extremely disciplined people. If we cooperate, the hunter-gatherer Shompen have every chance of surviving as hunter-gatherers and as well with us. There is an urgent need to prepare these documents to look into the health status of the champagne, prepare a detailed ethnographic report, and an action plan should be developed for the conservation of the champagne population. As the champagne are biologically, genetically, culturally distinct population living on the earth, it is the duty of all of us to save this aboriginal population before they extinct from the planet. The need of the hour is to take the advice of a true anthropologist who has dedicated his life for the welfare of the tribes of Andaman and Nicobar Islands and India.